everybody, it's Nina. Thanks for joining me today for a new Studio Monday video. Today I'm going to be featuring some Lawn Fawn products and showing you how to create spinner cards. Spinner cards are so much fun because you get some really fun just effects from opening the card and the critter or element that you have inside spins around and creates such a fun interactive touch to your card. Now, Lawn Fawn has this really cute Berry Happy Holidays stamp set, which is what I'm using here to stamp this little bear that's ice skating. This set is perfectly designed to be able to create spinner cards. Here you can see a colored version of that stamp set. I'm going to show you how I colored this one here. I am creating a total of two cards today, so you will see me using both this bear that we're working on right now and the other bear that I just showed you that was all colored in. You're going to be seeing me use those interchangeably throughout the card design. So this particular bear, I decided I wanted to turn into a panda. So I'm adding a stripe down the middle of the bear, and I'm making sure to thicken up the lines a little bit so that it matches the lines of the original drawing of the bear. To color in the panda, I used a few C markers. I used C4 for the base color. I also used a bit of C00 for the shading on the white areas. Because the shading of the panda bear on the white areas needs to be white, I don't want to add too much shading because I don't want it to look gray. So I just used a very light C00 and a little bit of C2 in certain spots. For the rest of the panda, I went with C8, C6, and then like I said, the C4 is the base color for the black areas. On the scarf, I used RV55, and then I also brought in a slightly darker RV marker and added a little bit of shading to there as well. This bear in particular is extremely easy to color because there's not a lot of area that is very small, and there's also not a layer area that needs lots of different colors. So it's a very simple image to color. You don't need tons of marker shades. You can see here I used just a few shades for each area of the bear. I also added a little bit of extra detail to the bear by adding some blush to its cheeks. That was with an R30 marker, and I also filled in the ears as well. Now for the back side of the bear, I colored it exactly the same. The only difference with the bear here is that I made sure to keep the areas that were towards the front of the bear a little bit lighter because the front of the bear has the shading kind of like around the edges, so the light is coming almost directly in front of the bear. So I wanted to make sure when I add the shading to the back that the areas that are closer towards the front have the lighter areas. Now you don't really have to worry about light source on this, but I did a little bit, so that's why I went ahead and mentioned that here as I'm coloring. So once I finished, I cut out the bear using the coordinating die set. There's a die for both the front and the back side, so I'm going to go ahead and cut those out. And now I'll add some little details with a white gel pen just to finish up the bear and make it look even more interesting. So now let's get started on creating the spinner card. So I'm first taking this really great Dancing Snowflakes die from Memory Box, and I'm going to cut this from a piece of white cardstock twice. I'm going to use one for each card, and this is creating a really fun snowflake frame that's going to go around my spinner area. Now this particular die matches really nicely with the Lawn Fawn Mini Snowflakes dies, and I'll show you how I use the Mini Snowflakes dies to decorate these frames even more. What you're seeing me do now is I'm taking those frames that I die cut with the Dancing Snowflakes and I'm adding them onto 4¼-inch pieces of cardstock, which are my card bases. So these are folded 4¼-inch square cards. Now I'm taking a oval die from Lawn Fawn's Magic Slider die set. I only chose this because it was the size that I wanted and it fit the bear perfectly. You can use any type of shape to cut a window into the front flap of your card. Just the front flap, you don't want to cut into the backside. So here you can see we've got a little window area, and then our frame's going to sit on top of this and create a really fun frosted edge around our card base. It's really, really fun and cozy card design. So we've got our window ready to go, and now I can go ahead and take some liquid glue and add that frame down onto the card bases. I did the exact same thing for both cards. I'm creating both cards exactly the same way. So what you see me do on one card, I did the exact same thing on the other. So I've attached that frame down onto my 4¼ square card, and then I also cut some squares of cardstock. They're a little bit smaller than the front flap, so it's like maybe about a 4-inch square, and I also cut that same oval shape into the center of those. This is how we're going to create the sandwich for our little spinner elements. So we need to create first the spinner element with the bear. So I'm going to take some length of thread. This is just some plain thread that you can get at any craft store. and I'm putting a piece of score tape and some liquid glue around one side of the bear. Now I chose the piece of tape in the center because I knew this was going to hold down the thread really easily, and then the liquid glue I'm just going to put around the areas that didn't get covered by the tape. I'm going to lay that thread right into the center area of the bear, making sure I press that down into the tape so it holds down in place. Then I will take the other half of the bear and sandwich that thread inside of my two bear images. Now I've got my thread completely adhered down, and this is what's going to hold the bear kind of suspended into the center of the card, and this is what's going to allow it to spin. You can already kind of see the concept going here. Now I need to pull that thread taut and adhere it down onto the back side of my card front. I'm making sure to pull the thread taut really, really tight because we don't want it to be floppy or anything, because you're not going to get that same spinning effect. So by pulling it really tight, you get this really nice taut thread, and that's what allows the bear to spin. And it is so cute, isn't it? Now you can do this with other images. It will be a little bit harder because you definitely need a front and a back, but you can create spinner cards using other images as well. However, Lawn Fawn's stamp sets that are designed to work with the spinner card designs are so easy to use, and you can see how quickly and simple this card was to put together. Now, you remember me mentioning those mini snowflake dies? Well, this is where I brought them in here. I'm bringing in some Simon glitter cardstock, and I'm going to take those snowflake dies, and I'm going to cut them twice for each card, so I'm going to have a total of two sets of snowflakes for each of these two cards. Now that may seem like a lot of snowflakes, but we're going to cover a lot of the snowflakes that are in that dancing snowflake die pattern, and we're going to embellish that with these snowflakes from the Lawn Fawn set. These snowflake dies coordinate really perfectly with that dancing snowflake die set, and so by using the mini snowflakes and the dancing snowflake dies, I was able to create a really fun snowflake pattern on my card that really looked nice. So now what you see me taking here are a couple pieces of cardstock. I chose two pieces of cardstock for each of the cards. On each card, of course, I chose different cardstocks because I use different colors on each card. But I'm prepping them with my little embossing powder bag, and then I'm going to take some sentiments from a couple of Lawn Fawn stamp sets. So I've got a Let It Snow stamp from the Snowy Backdrops set, and I've also got a sentiment from the Berry Happy Holidays. I've mounted them onto my clear blocks in an arc, so that way they kind of arc around the top of the oval really nicely. I'm stamping them in embossing ink from Simon Says Stamp, and then I'll bring in some Brutus Monroe Alabaster White embossing powder. I've used this embossing powder a lot lately, and I've really liked both the way it melts and the dimension it gives, and also the bright white of the powder itself. So I'm cutting out that arced sentiment, and I'm going to be popping this up off of my card along with a coordinating sentiment that I stamped onto a banner from the Berry Happy Holidays stamp set. And like I said, I stamped those both onto the two sheets of coordinating cardstock that I had picked out to match with each card. Both of the sentiments I'm popping up with two layers of foam tape onto my card. The banner is going to go down at the bottom, and then the arced sentiment is going to go across the top of that oval. To finish up the card, I added a little frame from a memory box die set and also some sparkle onto the skates and also the scarf. And so now you can see that awesome and so much fun spinner element of this card. It is really easy and fun to do. One thing you'll want to remember is that when you go to put this card in the mail, make sure you wind the little bear up before you put it into the envelope, because that way when somebody opens the card, it'll spin just like this. And trust me, the effect is perfect, because I actually gave a couple of these cards away to some friends and they loved it. They was like total surprise. They had such a blast. They were spinning those cards up so many times after I gave it to them, and really a lot of people really enjoy this card design. So I hope you will try it, because really it's very easy to do, and I hope that it has inspired you to either try the spinner design or just some inspiration for using the Berry Happy Holidays stamp set from Lawn Fawn. Either way, I hope you enjoyed this video and got some inspiration. Here are two more videos you might like featuring some fun Lawn Fawn ideas. Thanks so much for stopping by and spending some time with me today. I will be back next week with another video. And until then, thanks for watching. Bye!